things. Looks beautiful in here. Yeah, we will be going soon, Gohan. I didn't bring oil, so I'm hoping these little sausages will release a bit of oil. I wanna toast the bread. And here, I was boiling the water a little bit too long, so half of it evaporate. Oops. There you go. He didn't eat my breakfast. Hi everyone. Good morning. How was your sleep, Danny?
12 hours.
Wow, that's a good one. So we have a morning reading for you about information about the canal. It's from a book that was written about all the canal ways in Ireland, and we're reading chapter that describes the trip from Tullamore to Harbor Shannon Harbor, but we are walking the other way around, so we will have to, after reading, translate it backwards. So if it's a head toward that bridge, we need to understand that we have to go the other way around. So here, Danny, you go.
This tour encompasses one of the most pleasant and least peopled stretches of the entire Grand Canal line, particularly the stretch from Pollagh village to Belmont, a distance of about 13.7 kilometers. The stretch to the east and west of Macartney Aqueduct is mainly grass and gets very boggy in winter and after prolonged periods of rainfall. The towpath is well defined along the entire route, with a combination of tarmacadam changing to rough path, in turn changing to grass. This tour covers a stretch of the canal that was constructed in the very early years of the 19th century, while the canal was completed in 1803. There were early difficulties in making it passable due to regular breaches in the bogland areas it traversed, and it was not until 1805 that it was permanently secured after almost 2 years of work staunching its weakest parts. The route passes through a lengthy stretch of bogland, traversing the Brosna Valley and keeping close to the course of the River Brosna. Thomas Homer, the canal's first engineer, originally planned to make this river navigable when he set out his early plans for the canal, but it was subsequently decided to pursue a separate still water navigation.
Okay, that's it for today. Maybe we do lunch reading or tomorrow some more. Bye for now. Huh? Are you going in the river? Come on, bunny. Really? Calming down, Gohan. How was it, huh? Honey, what is it?
Peanut butter.
And we're having picnic before we head in that way. I love the bench. This is a swing bridge. Do you see the wheels under? It's built for a train. Oh my goodness, that's how it swings. So we're hoping to get to the city or little village called Pollagh. I don't know how to pronounce it. I will write it in the description of the video if I manage to post it today for you. And there is a special dedicated cycling shop for the Grand Canal Way, so we hopefully will find things that we need. The most urgent thing, it's power bank, because we don't have enough power. I can recharge the phone with my power bank 3 times, and I'm on the second go now, so I thought it's like one full phone battery for one day, but that's not happening. We're spending much more for filming and messages and other stuff. Daniel's phone is completely dead. So if anyone has a power bank who could borrow me or get me one, so let us know. We will really appreciate that. It will really help. Okay, bye bye for now.
Hi everyone.
It's end of the day 2. We put up the tent at 5 o'clock already. The location is not so good because of the road. What's wrong with the road, Danny?
It's
like a gravel or something.
Yeah, like gravel.
Yeah, it's not good. But I'm gonna cook dinner. What are we having for dinner?
Rice, chicken fillet, and sweet chili sauce.
Yeah, we are gonna enjoy the rest of the day and go sleep early. It was hard. We did very well, yeah. He did very well. He even ran. Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye.